Hey, what's up? Chris here. I'm going to show you five different expressions that I use pretty frequently in After Effects to help me work faster, work smarter, not harder. Number one, we have this loop in and out expression. Okay, so as you can see, I have this bouncing ball animation, but it doesn't loop. If you want to do a simple loop out, you can just alt-click on the stopwatch to add an expression and add loop out. Unfortunately, that only loops out. We want this to loop in and out. Here's how you do that. You option click on the stopwatch and add this expression, loop in plus loop out minus value. If you add that to both of these properties, you now have a bouncing ball that loops in and it loops out. That's all there is to it. You can use this expression to loop in and out of your keyframes and stop copying and pasting things like a chump. Expression number two, maintain stroke width. Okay, so what if you have a couple shape layers and they animate all cool? Unfortunately, if I scale these layers up, the stroke width scales with it. If I don't want that to happen, I can use this simple expression. Head over to aereference.com and search maintain stroke width, and then copy this expression to clipboard. If you go back to your comps and you search for stroke width, option click on the stopwatch and paste the magical expression. Do that for both of these layers. No matter what scale you make these layers, the stroke width will stay the same. Credit goes to Adam Pluff of BattleAxe.co for figuring out this expression. You can do whatever you want now, and if you apply that expression, it'll keep the stroke width the same. Expression number three, inherit parent's opacity. Here I have three different layers, and each of these text layers is parented to the box below it. I want them to get the opacity from those boxes. If I head over to aereference.com, I can search for opacity and find inherit parent opacity. Copy this to the clipboard, option click on the child layer's opacity, paste the expression, and then do that for each of these layers. If we go back, you can see that each of the layers has inherited the opacity of the parent layer. Say I want to fade all these layers out together. If I apply the same expression to each of the boxes and then parent those all to a null, I can then keyframe only the null and it'll control the opacity of all of the layers below it. This expression is simple, but by driving the opacity of a child by the parent, you can keyframe in one place instead of having to keyframe everywhere. It's great for revisions, it's great for group changes. You can basically control a bunch of layers with one property. Expression number four, ignore parent rotation. Here I've set up a little comp where I have a bunch of children parented to a null. I want the children to rotate around, but not to actually spin upside down like that. So I need the children to ignore the parent rotation. This expression is simple enough that we'll just type it out. I'm gonna grab all the child layers, hit R for rotation, alt-click on the stopwatch and type value minus parent.transform.rotation. If I click out of there, you can see that this child is now staying upright no matter how the parent rotates. Right-click, copy expression only, and paste it onto all the other child layers. And just like that, you've got a rig that lets you rotate a parent without affecting the individual rotation of the child layers. Use this expression to set up cool rigs where things are spinning, other things aren't spinning. Use your imagination. Number five, the last one. Here's the same rig from the previous video with our spinning baby Yoda. This time, however, the null doesn't just spin, it also scales up. We don't want the Yodas to inherit the parent scale either, so we're gonna go ahead and apply this expression. If we go to aereference.com, hit slash to search and type scale. Ignore parent scale. So this one has two different options. I'm gonna go ahead and grab this first one here since our parent layer does not have a parent. We're gonna copy this. We'll grab the scale property of one of these layers. We'll option click and then paste this expression on the scale property. Now you can see one of these layers is not affected by the scale of the parent null. Right click, copy expression only, and then paste the same expression onto all the other baby Yodas. By combining this expression and the ignore parent rotation expression, we can create this setup where we can rotate and scale a null without affecting the individual properties of the child layer. Use this to build rigs for spinning products and for all sorts of other stuff. And that's the end of our five simple expressions. If you're thinking about learning expressions, there's kind of two different ways you can go. You can go like, I don't want to mess with expressions. I'm just going to animate everything manually. I'm just going to set keyframes for everything. And that can be dangerous because you end up duplicating your efforts a lot. You can end up working slower. Someone who knows how to use expressions might be able to work faster and they're probably going to get the jobs. The other way you can go is to try to over-engineer everything. And you don't want to do this either. If you're not saving yourself time by reducing the amount of duplicate efforts, or if you're trying to get out of doing some hard animation by just trying to let the computer do it, you're probably overusing expressions. You want to look for that middle sweet spot where the expression saves you time. Maybe you have to put in a little more time setting it up in the beginning, but then when the client comes back with a change or your boss says, oh, I want this loop to be a little faster, and then you have to go back and edit all the keyframes and you're just like, bleh. Don't do that. Look for that sweet spot where a little bit of effort up front can save you a ton of time afterwards. Try to rig things, try to think about things as systems, about reducing duplicate efforts. And expressions will probably become your best friend. Anyway, hope you enjoyed this video. I hope it was helpful. If you want more tips like this, subscribe here on YouTube. Give this a like or a comment if you want. If you want to follow along with what I'm working on, head over to Twitter, Instagram. I'm trying to post short versions of these videos over on Instagram and Twitter. If you want to get the little tidbits, the little bite-sized nuggets of knowledge. If you want to head over to aereference.com, you can see more expressions that I like to use on a daily basis. I'm building this site kind of as a personal repository of things that I want to save, shortcuts, expressions. I want to add a lot more to it, but right now, it's mainly for expressions. If you want to check it out, go give it a look-see. Let me know what you think. Hope you find it useful. Peace.